is very vast in this area. Please, let's welcome Mr.
This program.
Very good morning to you.
Good morning, sir.
I have pleasure to share fellowship with you and the family. Just yesterday, I was at the Inoyo Model Theater, watching a play titled The New Nigeria. In 76 minutes, the director was able to reenact, I could say, a full composite of what Nigeria is, the good, the bad. Okay. But what was of more interest to me was that at the end of the 76 minutes, the resolution, for those of you who are literally just in the 10 minutes, the resolution was that the women were able to lead a revolution that led to the emergence of a new Nigeria. And when I was asked to comment, I said, well, let me say that this is prophetic. We have been praying for Nigeria in my group since 10th December last year when the elections were about to begin. And we're hearing so many stories about apocalypse. And we began to pray. We just praying for Nigeria. And yesterday was one of those days that we gathered to pray. And we had to start 1 hour earlier so that the entire team would go to the theater. And it's somehow that what we saw in Nigeria yesterday is actually the subject matter of our conversation for over a year now. So my prayer is that this profession and the education as a whole, not only in our Bible but in Nigeria, will be so totally transformed that our future will be assured.
Amen.
Let me ask you this, how many of us know that the life that we live really, the whole life that we live is through our relationships? Many people have ever considered the entire life that we live is all about relationships.
Yes.
You know, I tell you, the Christian faith, the first 5 commandments, relationship between God and man, last 5 commandments, relationship between man and man. Then Paul summarizes it. He says the whole purpose of his life says, here do I strive to exercise myself in a conscious way of offense, based on what God and towards me. So our lifetime on this is actually, you know, about relationships. And we want to take a look at the relationship between mentor and mentee in this session. I guess that if you take a look at our learning objectives as professional educationists, you will find something not quite appropriate. Am I right?
Yeah.
Am I right?
Yes.
Okay. Because you have said that your objective should be demonstrated, should be in bed form. I don't know how you get measure, understand? How you measure no, and how you measure no. So can we together change that?
Yes.
Let's change it and go together. What can we, how can we frame that Facebook? Yes, I think, is that good enough?
Yes.
I think that is good enough.
Yes.
Okay, the second one.
States.
Yes.
Okay. Mark, is that all right?
States is okay.
Describe also fits in there. And the last one.
States.
Thank you. So we now have that. That is the roadmap. That is our roadmap. We're not going to spend any time. Let's just take the next slide. And look at the structures. Next slide. As you begin to embark on this job, Doctor, I had to sit out with your mentor this morning before coming here. Because I didn't just want to talk about theory. And that government job produced three other grand mentors. Is that not remarkable?
Mm-hmm.
I want to suggest that we should bring such a person here. In fact, I think she's more qualified to study where I'm standing.
Yeah.
Because she has done it practically and very successfully. The reason why I went to seek her out is that I just wanted to learn from her firsthand the practical, nitty-gritty aspect of mentoring within the system we operate. I have practically dealt with mentoring in administration. That man that is sitting there is my friend and my brother. You know, I didn't go out to seek him to be my mentor, but he came to me. And we just work together as a brother, and I'm really very proud of him because he really has been a good mentee. So, you have these three structures. You can have the informal, you can have what is in between the hybrid, and you can have the formal. If I go to the comment, I will say take the hybrid, combine elements of the informal and the formal. Now, in the first one, associates can just identify each other. And for me, I believe that the most effective leadership emerges. Spiritual leadership emerges. Not when you call out somebody and pour a bottle of oil on him, and they say you're a pastor, and they say, spiritual leadership emerges. If three people gather and begin to fellowship together, after 1 week or 2 weeks, all of them in that room will know who is a leader for them. Am I right?
Yes.
And they will just give him the respect naturally. So in a work environment, you can just see people that emerge as leaders because of their practice, you know, because of the competencies and because of the things that they deliver again and again.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they can just attract you like a map, naturally. So it's one way that we can begin to select, you know, an informal way that we can select a mentor, and that one is less with you. As I said, this one for my elements of both. The former clearly is defined with time constraints. A little bit more rigid, and I wanted to find out if the Toro Foundation tries to interfere to emphasize more the form, and I was told that they do not actually form part of the process of their selecting. Let's just take the next slide. We're not going to stay on this, but you can just see what we have there. It's natural to select from your work area. And for the informal, having formal meetings, and the need arises. And if you are blessed to have a teacher in the same environment that is actually mentoring you, you can be very wonderful. And the duration of the relationship, of course, will not be predetermined. As you measure the level of your success, you cannot determine whether you want to wrap up on the process or there is cycle or to continue. Well, yes, thanks. Let's go to slide number 11 and then we will turn it. Now, just preparation to select a mentor. Those are the conditions we are willing to, because when I talk with this woman today, I was surprised at her diversity of the school she selected and the distance between them. But she was able to do it. And I think that I could put it down to just one simple word, passion. When you select somebody from your high school, somebody from Tiago, you select somebody from Seik or Mama, can you imagine that? And you bring them together in four terms. And I asked her, how did you, what was their greatest challenge? She said she has. Because often she had to pay the bills, pay the transport to the venue of the music, or the interaction, do the refreshment. But over time, as the relationship developed, they also began to make offer. This one was, I will provide the drinks. The other one will say, I will provide the other aspect of the refreshment, and they will just contribute. And this is what this is all about, what we are talking about here. How are you going to develop the relationship between yourself and the mentee up to the point that you are able to achieve the goal that you intend to achieve? So you look for people who are interested, are willing to give the very best that is possible, and that will make themselves available. First of all, as a mentor, you prefer to provide a mentee with accurate information. It's part of the confidence building. Do you understand that?
Yes.
Because if you give me information that I find out later is not quite reliable, it begins to weigh down on, you know, the respect, the mutual respect between the two. Secondly, the mentor has to be willing, very passionate about supporting the mentee in reaching the stated goals, which will be done at the very beginning of the relationship. Both teaching time together should be able to determine the goals that they want to achieve. Thirdly, because we do not want that mentor that crowds in on the mentee to respect the mentee's decision. It doesn't always mean that the mentee must take all the advice that is given by the mentee. Do you understand that?
Yes.
Sometimes he or she could decide not to travel with that. And you have to respect the decisions, you know, and the goals that is given by the mentee. This is a little tricky. Challenge the mentee when it is there is very important. This is all about challenging somebody to come out of his or her shell. Because the basic assumption is that the mentee has what to offer. The mentor's responsibility is to make that person realize his potential, harness, and manifest it. You have to be trustworthy. I think the lady was talking about issues of confidentiality when I came in. That is very, very important. Somebody gives information, the information begins and ends on that table. No paper. Be able to find the mentee with good ideas and suggestions. Very, very important. You know, from the back of the experience that you have, just like this. I hope we can run fast. Well, you can adopt the two approaches once again of selecting a mentee. Can be the former, and it can be the direct or the indirect approach. For the direct approach, it will be interesting to listen to. Maybe one or two or three of the mentors that have passed through this room and have done very well. You should express interest in being a mentor to others. That is the direct approach. Just ask if there is anyone you would like to mentor. The person I talked to said she spoke with a lot of her mates and tried to find out teachers that are passionate about what they do and won't be interested in traveling along the route of the competition to excel. Just find out from the colleagues, and they mentioned people, one in the York High School, the other at the other she was actually traveling with together to work, somehow made contact with this and selected seven, which is now submitted to the foundation before she started. Now you can also extend yourself by creating opportunities to get to know the potential mentee. I have an open door policy. I talk to people. I talk about my experience and the process of it. Then you can be able to choose a mentee. The indirect approach. Here you create an environment where the potential mentee will want to learn from you. There are people that are locked up. This attitude of a typical, in the new Nigeria, we don't have that. Oh, they don't dare go. After they get information, say they get into that, what I'm so. Because we do not see anything like this. I think that the progressive and forward-looking way is to tell your colleagues trade secrets deliberately. In human resource management, we say there is no success without succession. That is, if you are down to principal, you leave that school, you cannot produce somebody who can do the things you do your criteria. Because I have seen in practical and full relief that the principal governs the spirit of the school. No matter how good a principal is, a bad principal will run down the tone of the school within 2 weeks. I've seen it again and again and again. So no matter what you do, if you cannot find a replacement, nature will call it cloning talents. Cloning high performance. You have to be able to produce somebody like yourself who can do the thing that you have to do very well. You can encourage people to come to you as grace, encourage and challenge potential mentees, initiate a relationship that is based on common interest. Number four, very important, help new teachers get settled into their work and feel welcome. I don't know, the very first day that teacher, especially one who is not a professional teacher, the first day that he or she stands before the students. Can you describe the experience they have? Very, very, very serious experience. But then, you know, if you become interested, you are there, you have been a senior teacher in the school and need to talk about that long, and you make friends. Encouraging, starting off is part of the process of mentoring. And you know, a relationship is easily begin. Look beyond the junior. You know, the new and the juniors can maintain a relationship with peers and other experienced teachers, of course. Anybody, I've always said so, anybody can be a mentor. Even a driver, taxi driver can be what? If you are willing to suffer, you can get through money to come here.